क्वेश्चन नंबर वन सेज इन एन आइसोसेलियस ट्रायंगल एबीसी विद एबी इज इक्वल टू एसी द बाइसेक्टर्स ऑफ एंगल बी एंड एंगल सी इंटरसेक्ट्स ईच अदर एट पॉइंट ओ जॉइन ए टू ओ शो दैट ओबी इज इक्वल टू ओसी. ओके सो फॉर दैट फर्स्ट यू नीड टू ड्रॉ द डायग्राम. सो इन एन आइसोसेलियस ट्रायंगल लेट्स से एबीसी. सो लेट्स से आई हैव ड्रॉन वन आइसोसेलियस ट्रायंगल. लेट्स से दिस पॉइंट इज ए, दिस पॉइंट इज बी, एंड दिस पॉइंट इज C. In an isosceles triangle ABC with AB is equals to AC, please. इधर देख लीजिए. AB is equals to AC. This is given in the question. So or again write it here that AB is equals to AC. This is given in the question. Now, next thing, the bisectors of angle B and angle C intersect each other at point O. So obviously, bisector of angle B. It's like this, and bisector of angle C is like this, right? And these two bisectors meet each other at point O. So this is given in the question that OB is the angle bisector of angle B. OB is the angle bisector of angle B. Similarly, OC is the angle bisector of angle C. That means this angle is equal to this one and this angle is equal to this one. Do you agree with this?
Yes, sir.
If OB and OC are angle bisectors of angle B and angle C respectively, so I can say ABO is equal to OBC, right? I can write ABO is equal to OBC and ACO is equal to OCB. OB and OC are the angle bisectors of angle B and angle C respectively. Any doubt on this point? Now join A to O. Join A to O. This is given in the question. So I have joined A and O. Now show that OB is equal to OC. OB is equal to OC. This you need to prove. Okay? OB is equal to OC. So okay, I'll write it here to prove. OB is equal to OC. Okay, so here it is given that OBC is equals to OCB, and the reason behind is OB and OC are the angle bisectors of angle B and angle C. Okay, so OBC. Okay, before that, AB is equals to AC is given.
Yes, sir.
AB is equals to AC is given in the question, so you can say angle C and angle B both are equal because AB is equals to AC. So you can say angle C is equal to angle B. Angle C is equal to angle B. May I know the reason? If I am saying that AB is equal to AC, so I am writing here is angle C is equal to angle B. What could be the reason? Angles opposite to equal sides are equal. So angles opposite to equal side are equal, simple. So from this you can say angle B is equal to angle C if AB is equal to AC. ये चीज़ आपको पहले भी आपको बताई गई थी. अगर दो साइड्स बेटा इक्वल है किसी आइसोसेलियस ट्रायंगल की, सो ऑब्वियसली जो उनके ऑपोजिट एंगल्स होंगे वो भी क्या होंगे बेटा, इक्वल होंगे. एनी डाउट इन दिस? So from this I can say angle B is equal to angle C, and the reason is angle opposite to equal sides are also equal. That means if this complete angle is 2 theta, that means this angle is also equal to 2 theta. Angle B equals to angle C hai beta, then OBC jo hai and OCB hai, inhi ka to half hai. Now I can say, okay, I'll write it here, angle B and angle C. Okay, now angle B I can write OBC. Angle B is half half of angle OBC and OCB is half of angle C. Do you agree with this? Do you agree with this statement? What I have written, this is complete angle B. This is angle bisector. So obviously these two angles are equal. So this complete angle B is divided between these two angles. So I can write angle B, this complete angle B, and this is OBC. So OBC can be written as angle B, this is angle B. So I can write OBC. Okay, theek hai. OBC जो है आपका हाफ ऑफ एंगल बी है, इसको आप लिख सकते हैं बेटा ऐसे. सिमिलरली एंगल सी, ठीक है, जो आपका OCB है, OCB को आप क्या लिख सकते हैं बेटा, हाफ ऑफ एंगल सी. हाफ एंड हाफ गेट कैंसिल आउट, सो नाउ यू कैन राइट OBC इज इक्वल्स टू OCB, ठीक है बेटा. सो यहां से ये भी चीज कंफर्म होगी दैट दीस टू एंगल्स आर इक्वल टू वन अनदर. नाउ अगेन अप्लाई द सेम प्रॉपर्टी, corollary of this property, that is if two angles are equal then their opposite sides are also equal. So now you can use, you can say OB is equals to OC, OB is equals to OC, and the reason behind is corollary of this property, that is sides opposite to equal angles are equal. Any doubt? फिर से देख लीजिए बेटा, आपको एक ट्राइंगल गिवन था बेटा, आप मत लिखिए. आई जस्ट रिक्वेस्ट यू प्लीज डोंट राइट व्हाइल आई एम टीचिंग. लेट्स से यू हैव एन आइसोसेलियस ट्राइंगल, आपको एक आइसोसेलियस ट्राइंगल गिवन है इन व्हिच AB इज इक्वल्स टू AC. ये कंडीशन आपको गिवन थी, क्योंकि AB इज इक्वल्स टू AC है, सो ऑब्वियसली बेटा उसके ऑपोजिट के एंगल्स क्या होंगे, इक्वल होंगे, इसमें कोई डाउट नहीं है. सो वहां से हमने बोल दिया बेटा एंगल B इज इक्वल्स टू एंगल C, बिल्कुल करेक्ट. Then हमने बोला OB and OC are the angle bisectors of angle B and angle C, है ना? जो OB line है वो angle B को bisect कर रहा है, OC line angle C को bisect कर रहा है. Any doubt in this? No. अगर वो bisect कर रहा है, तो बेटा ये वाला angle कितना हो जाएगा? B by 2. ये वाला angle भी कितना हो जाएगा बेटा? B by 2. ये वाला angle C by 2 and ये वाला angle भी क्या हो जाएगा? C by 2. So OBC को बेटा मैंने OBC को मैं लिख सकता हूँ, या फिर मैं angle B यहाँ पे मैंने लिखा है, तो मैं लिख सकता हूँ OBC को मैं लिख सकता हूँ B by 2. सिमिलरली बेटा एंगल सी जो यहाँ पे ओ सी बी था, मैं इसको लिख सकता हूँ बेटा हाफ ऑफ एंगल सी, लिख सकता हूँ हाफ से हाफ कैंसिल आउट हो गया. सो बेटा हमने यहाँ पे कहा ओबीसी इक्वल्स टू ओसीबी, ओबीसी इक्वल्स टू ओसीबी हमने कह दिया. जैसे ही ये दो एंगल इक्वल आ गए बेटा, जैसे ही ये दोनों एंगल इक्वल आ गए, आपने क्या बोला, साइड्स ऑपोजिट टू इक्वल एंगल्स आर ऑल्सो इक्वल. एनी डाउट? सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट पार्ट, दिस द proof of first part, then we will move to the next part. First note down this thing, rather you can write, instead of writing half I can write double, because angle B can be written as twice of OBC. So twice of OBC and twice of, though again 2 se 2 cancel out ho jayega, you will get OBC is equals to OC. Note kar lijiye isko. Why I have written twice here? So angle B can be written as angle B is equals to ABO plus OBC, ABO plus OBC. These two angles are equal. So I can write angle B is equals to, I can write ABO. ABO is also equals to OBC. ABO is equals to OBC, right? So in place of ABO, I can write OBC now. So angle B is equals to OBC plus angle OBC, or I can write angle B is equals to twice of angle OBC. Any doubt? So angle B can be written as twice of OBC. So justify now. यहाँ पे आपने पूछा sir, why you have written twice? तो यहां पे मेरा उसका जस्टिफिकेशन है, why I have written twice है, इसीलिए बेटा मैंने half remove कर दिया, पर अब कुछ नहीं पड़ेगा, दोनों से वो proof हो जाएगा, but twice ही क्यों आएगा यहां पे, this is the justification for that. Similarly you can justify for angle C, okay, because these two angles are equal, so obviously this is B by 2, this is B by 2, this is C by 2, this is C by 2, okay. Now the next part is, in the second part you need to prove that OA bisects angle A. That means by somehow you need to prove that these two angles are equal. So you can prove these two angles equal by CPCT. For that you need to prove that these two triangles are congruent, right? So now I can write in triangle OAB and in triangle OCA, or I can write OAC. Now I am considering these two triangles. AB is equals to AC, right? AB is equals to AC, this is given in the question. Then ABO is equals to ACO, with the same reason that OB and OC bisects each other. Oh sorry, bisects angle B and angle C. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट थिंग इज यहाँ पे एक और चीज आप मेंशन करेंगे दैट एंगल बी इज इक्वल टू एंगल सी. ठीक है, ये आप लास्ट उसमें प्रूव कर चुके हैं दैट एंगल बी इज इक्वल टू एंगल सी. रीजन इज एंगल्स ऑपोजिट टू इक्वल साइड्स आर आल्सो इक्वल. सो एबीओ इज इक्वल टू एसीओ, एबीओ इज इक्वल टू एसीओ, सो दिस इज द एंगल. नाउ द नेक्स्ट थिंग इज ओबी इज इक्वल टू ओसी, ओबी इज इक्वल टू ओसी. This thing we have proved from the last part. Okay, last part में आपने यही proved किया था that OB is equals to OC. So जब आपने last part आपने proved किया, in that you can write like यहाँ पे OB equals to OC आपने last में लिखा है, वहाँ पे आप लिख सकते हैं equation number one. So इसके लिए reason आप क्या दे देंगे from equation one, or I can write it here from the last part, from part one, from part one. जो part one का solution था, from that you have OB is equals to OC. So side angle side, side angle side से आपका proof हो गया that these two triangles are congruent. Now you can write ABO, triangle ABO is similar and equals to triangle ACO by side angle side congruency rule. If these two triangles are congruent, that means their corresponding parts are also congruent or equal. So now I can say BAO is equals to CAO, right? BAO is equals to CAO, these two angles are equal by CPCT. If these two angles are equal, so in other words, I can say that AO bisects angle A. Okay, so आप यहाँ लिख सकते हैं. In the last step, you can write AO bisects angle A. Hence, any doubt till this step? So you people are free to ask. First, understand why I have chosen these two triangles, because I need to prove that BAO is equals to CAO. I need to show in this question that AO bisects angle A. For that, I have chosen these two triangles. These sides are equal. This is given in the question. OB is equals to OC. That this thing you have calculated in the last part. And ABO is equals to ACO. The reason behind is these two angles are equal because OB bisect OB and OC bisects angle B and angle C. And angle B is equals to angle C because angles opposite to equal sides are also equal. So in this way you have proved that this angle is equal to this one, this side is corresponding to this side, and this side is equal to this one. So side angle side, by using side angle side congruency rule, you have proved that these two triangles are congruent. If these two triangles are congruent, that means their corresponding parts are also equal or congruent. So from here you can calculate that you have, what you have observed, that these two angles are equal. If these two angles are equal, that means I can say AO bisects angle A. अगर ये दो equal angles हैं, इसका मतलब जो AO है उसने उसे bisect किया है, किसको? Angle A. ठीक है? Note it down fast. This is question number second. Read the question. Triangle ABC, AD is perpendicular bisector of BC. That means AD is perpendicular bisector of BC. That means you can say BD is equals to DC. Do you agree with this?
Yes, sir.
AD is the perpendicular bisector of side BC. This means that BD is equals to DC. Reason is AD is perpendicular bisector. Is perpendicular bisector of side, or you can say of side BC. From this, I have get the knowledge that AD, BD is equals to DC. Angle D is equals to angle D. That is ADB is equals to angle ADC is equals to 90 degrees. Correct?
Yes, sir.
Reason? Right angle. And this is given in the question itself, that this is perpendicular bisector. AD is perpendicular bisector, this is given in the question. So, yahan se beta aapko do aapko yahan se hint mile. First is BD is equals to DC, and the second hint is these two angles are equals to 90 degrees, that are right angle. So, this side is equals to this one, this angle is equals to this one, and this side is common. BD is equals to DC, angle D is equals to D, that is 90 degrees. And AD is equals to AD, that is common. So now I can say that these two triangles are bounded by side angle side. Any doubt?
No, sir.
This triangle. Show that angle ABC is an isosceles triangle in which AB is equals to AC. So to prove that AB is equals to AC, that is ABC is an isosceles triangle. ABC is an isosceles triangle. Now if these two triangles are congruent by side angle side congruency rule, so you can say ADB is equals to triangle. Using these three conditions, now you can say triangle ADB is similar and equals to triangle ADC by side angle side congruency rule. By side angle side congruency rule. This time I am writing it clearly, side angle side. Now, if these two triangles are congruent to each other using side angle side congruency rule, now I can say AB is equals to AC.
Yes, sir.
Can I write now AB is equals to AC?
Yes, sir.
By CPCT. Correct. By CPCT. Because AB is equals to AC, these are the corresponding parts of these two congruent triangles. So from here, now we can say AB is equals to AC. Correct? AB is equals to AC. Similarly, angle B is equals to angle C.
Yes, sir.
Again, angle B is equals to angle C by CPC, by the same reason CPC. So this is how you have proved that these two sides are equal. And the last you can write, that is triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Okay. Hence, any doubt in this step? Then please note it down fast. Question number 3, 4 and 5th. Question number 3rd, 4th and 5th is for your homework. Try these questions. But if you find any difficulty, you can ask me in the next class.